Hello everyone, this is Mr. Morales. In this video I will show you how to modify margins and create sections and create columns. A margin is a space between the edge of the document and the edge of the text. There is the left margin, top margin, right margin, and bottom margin. We modify the margin by going to the ribbon, going to the layout tab, and under the page setup group, the command all the way to the left is margins. We click on margins and we get many preset margins. If we notice all the way at the bottom, we have custom margins. We click on that. We get the page setup dialog box, and here we have the option of increasing or decreasing our margins. I will decrease it to 0.8. I will decrease the margins to 0.8. I'm changing the top, left, bottom, and right margins only. We also have the option of changing the orientation to landscape, or we can keep it as portrait. I click OK and now the margins were changed. Let's take a look at our document. This is supposed to be a newsletter, but it's missing something. It doesn't look like a newsletter. A newsletter has columns. So what we're going to do in order to create those columns, we need to create sections. Because if we just create the columns here under the layout tab, and I can just create two columns, this doesn't look right. So I create sections, which are portions of documents, and when you create a section, you're able to format each section differently. Before creating our section, we're going to right-click on the status bar. The status bar is all the way at the bottom of your document. We right-click on the status bar, and the second item from the top, it's called Section. We click on that, and we make sure that there's a check mark on it. Then we click on our document, and we can see from that change all the way to the left of the status bar that we are in section 1. Now I'm going to create a new section. Under the layout tab, under the page setup group, there's a button, a command called breaks. I click on that and I have different page breaks. We have a section for page breaks and then we have our section breaks. You can read about what each of those breaks do. We're going to focus on the continuous section break. The continuous section break creates a new section on the same page. Before I click on a break though, I want to make sure that I'm on the proper section in my document or proper area in my document. So I click right before the word overview. I make sure the insertion point is right before the word overview. Now I can go to the layout tab, and actually let's do one more thing. Let's go to the home tab. Let's go to the paragraph group and click on the show hide command. The cursor is still before the overview, the word overview. Now let's go to the layout tab, click on the breaks command, and let's click on continuous. As you can see, a new section break was created, and you can see a line right above the word overview and right below the words improving your health through a well-balanced diet. If I click on the title where it says nutrition time and I look at my status bar under section, I notice that it's under section 1. If I click below the section break, now I'm on section 2. The purpose of this is that now I can modify section 2 without modifying section 1. So make sure that you click under section 2 anywhere in section 2, and now I can create a column or columns in this part of the document. We're still on the layout tab. Let's go to the columns command. We have several options. We also have more columns option. Here you have even more options. I'm just going to click on 2 as my number of columns and my presets. I click OK. And now I've just changed my document, and now it looks more like a newsletter. Let's do one more thing. Let's create a box around this quote or on this italicized text. So I select the text. I go to the Home tab. Under the paragraph group, the command is called Borders. I'm going to click on the down arrow, and here I have many options of creating a border surrounding the text. I go all the way at the bottom where it says Borders and Shading, and I can specify exactly what kind of border I want. I'm going to click on the box under Setting. Here are different styles. I'll choose the third style. I can change the color if I want. I can change the width of the border. We can choose 1 point. It's going to be applied to the text that I've selected. I click OK. And now I have a border around the text. I don't like the way it looks, so I'm going to undo. I'm going to select my text again. I'll go to under the paragraph mark. I'll go to the borders again. Let's go borders and shading. I'll add box as my setting. I'll just keep it simple with the style and the color, the default. I'll leave the width as 1 point, and this time I'll apply it, make sure that it's applied to paragraph. I click OK, and notice now the box is surrounding the text without it being underlined the way it was before. I can change the color of the background color of the inside the box by going to the paragraph group and the shading command. I click on the little down arrow and I have different options for colors. I'll choose one of the gold colors. I can also select my text and I can decrease the width of the box by going to the horizontal ruler and the left indent, which is a little square. I click and drag that about half an inch, and I do the same thing with the right indent, which is a little triangle. Also half an inch. and I created a nice professional looking box that adds some style to my newsletter. This concludes this video. I'll see you in the next video.